So I'll be finishing the plate for you, except also now that I'm first thing that I teach is teaching you about how to serve properly. You do see a lot of people holding the plate like that, keeping it around for half an hour. But not the way that we do it. What we do, by elbowing your hip, by closing your hand back, leaving this crowd here and this bit here, and literally lean into it. Okay? You're videoing me?
Yeah.
This hand here goes to the centre, pushes down.
Oh my god.
Now then, on a large level plate, it's called coning up. We squeeze the plate, and it's going to come up to about here. Alright? And then tilt it over and spin back into the middle. Okay? You do this by chance.
Twins.
I was going to say, oh now I can see. Do you want to dress the same with your parents make you? Okay, I thought you were. I've sort of two separate scary friends that work on this twins. Nightmare going shopping. But anyway, pushing forward, literally. Squeeze now. Let go. Now the third line's going up. Tilt it over. Evenly. Okay.
Why is it?
It gets to play the same consistency. It's a very, very short body. You try and move this a bit like quicksand. If you just tap it slightly, it will stop and move. It's a very, very short body. It's like calcium powder water. It's very, very fine.
Okay.
So in order to get the inside of there malleable enough for me to throw the pot, I have to draw it up. Okay.
Yeah. Show you
If you start to pull, you cannot really push it down. You have to chew it and then push it down. Why?
Yeah. Otherwise you'd be doing that.
Okay.
You want to point it off in the direction, it comes out and then wants to come back into your hand. And then your hand directs it back over the centre.
Okay.
You just try and push it down. It's going to go that way.
Okay.
So I tell it to go that way, but the wheel tells it to come back into the centre.
Alright. So the wheel can ask it to come back into the centre. Okay.
Now then, find the middle, right hand on the outside, thumb on the outside, direct thumb across, find the centre, thumb. I've already measured the top of my knuckle there, the bottom of my thumb there, alright? Yeah. I don't want that clay at the bottom through the pot ring. I don't want to hit or go through the bottom of the pot. Good indication, roughly, right. Two fingers on the left hand, two fingers forward. Should we do something similar to this? Should we do right hand, left hand? Two thumbs in and pulling it out, okay? So I do something different, I can keep my right hand free, and I can pull out. Relax, and let go. Inside, two thumbs, two fingers behind your thumb, on the centre, push out. Straighten up the walls. turn thumbs up, and you'll be squeezing in, pushing in like that, making a volcano shape. I use it a little more difficult. Got a pinch and lift the pitch on middle finger, my thumb. It only comes the other pinch. From the middle to the edge, pinch it, push it in, and lift it. Okay?
Asymmetric.
I can do an octagon one. I can do eight sided. I can't do a square one.
How often you have to add water?
When your hands go dry.
Okay, so your hand has to keep moisture.
Or when the face starts to grip. Starts to grip, starts to snag, Now, what I'm going to do now is push in the bottom and pull out the top. Okay, so go from there to the cylinder. Very gently squeeze, play in like that. Shake your lift. And let's put a knuckle in. So, my flat top and knuckle is a little head like so. There's my nail there. My hand is. Push the clay onto my nail there. Now, imagine, you still need that one to take the bottom. So, from my nail to the bottom of my finger, that's still the foot ring. Don't go any lower than there. So, that goes to the side. This hand goes in. You won't all be able to see this. This hand goes in. It's my nail. What is
it? What does that do? Make it a cylinder.
It's in the clay from the bottom to the top.
Yeah.
Narrow at the top and the bottom.
What I was thinking, how to make the water out. I put a hole at the bottom. No.
Well, what happened to the vase?
All right, then.
No. I think the first one, probably the last, probably was going to say this to me, no, you wouldn't put a hold on it. I mean, you probably would, if you couldn't get in there with the sponge. Get it from the Romans. From the Romans, you still would have worked something like that. You're going to be getting your own now, don't you? Bit of vinegar. I have 3 6 sizes of me, just in case they think of it. You can have a little one like that. Right, we're now going to push the clay onto this rib here to get rid of all this gooey stuff, all the wet paint, straighten up the outside.